You offend me a lot. Mm-hmm. Every now and then, I'm just
saying. So if he's abroad now, if he's abroad now, you now see why. What I love what we are discussing, because this kind of discussion is making me to know that whenever I'm traveling out, there is no permanent visa for this thing.
God forbid, it's not in your
hand. The visa I will get for her is the one that almost returned back to Nigeria. Yes.
It's not in your hand.
Women have the capacity of changing. That is just the issue. They have the capacity of changing overnight. And when they will change, it will be like chameleon. Yes. Oma and Kapu, they are like carnival. Oma and Kapu. So,
Columbus, please.
Yes, coming.
Where are you?
Come. I'm up here. I cannot walk down.
Put your hands up.
Okay.
What's going on?
I killed my wife.
Come downstairs.
I cannot come.
Why not?
My feet is broken. She broke my feet. I cannot walk. So I wait when she sleeps again. My foot is
broken. Don't move.
I can't move.
Don't move.
My feet is broken.
Where is she at?
She's in there. I killed her. I use a hammer and a knife.
188, can you run some cars into us?
She broke my foot, so I did it to
her. Hey, if you want to glove up, don't move.
I will never move. I called you guys. I didn't run.
What's your name?
Hassan. Hassan Majani.
What happened to the back of your leg?
What happened? I just actually moved my camera because she... We were talking. She pushed me on the step. I fell. She scratched me. So I managed to climb up. I waited till she slipped. I took the hammer and killed her.
You killed her with a hammer?
And a knife, yes.
And a knife. Where's the knife? Where's the hammer?
Everything is in there.
Love is supposed to be something that makes you smile forever. But you know what? Not all are actually privileged to enjoy the forever part of love. And that is why today, our searchlight is on the challenges being faced by African men and women outside the continent of Africa. Most African men are not finding it funny with their imported wives in the Western world, especially in the US, because the system there actually empowers women against the men. And that is what we want to be considering today. Let's dive into it.
Good day, everyone. This is Dazzle, the most handsome, yakable, Africanicious, utterly pumping, and physical power husband. And as usual, I have my most scintillating, pepperoni, sugarlicious, hot baby girl beside me.
Good day, everyone. It's a pleasure having you today on the setrosvlog family. Thank you for those that have been liking, subscribing, and sharing. If you have not yet subscribed, please do. And today's discussion is something that we just have to discuss as a family. Globally,
it is no longer news that majority of men outside the continent of Africa are beginning to see what we call wahoo lens, because the so-called imported girlfriend that has been upgraded into a wife status are now the concern of their life, as most African men are beginning to just attack their so-called wife, which is becoming something more gruesome that can be imagined.
Mr. Cetro, I'm not going to agree with you like that. You know, the system right here in Africa gives the authority to the men, and they like to usurp the authority. Even there are some tribes here in Nigeria that women are not counted to be anything. When you give birth to a female child and you've not even given birth to male children, they'll count you as if you're nothing. And I think these women, actually, they've gone through a lot. We're not going to be, it's not one way now. So getting there to another society whereby they are empowered, so they now want to show their power, and it's now going the wrong way. I think it's both ways. They just have to be addressed. People have to be honest. What are leading to it? And children are involved in this. Underage children are involved in this. Are they going to continue reproducing this type of experiences? It's just too much. And there's something with the nursing profession. Once that woman becomes a registered nurse, it's just as if something is in
that. Before you start going there, the men, please draw closer. I have one question for my wife. Please, if I import you or export you to America or any of these Western nations, and I decide to enroll you to be a registered nurse, since we all know that maybe that's the angle where enough money is coming to the family, Do you think or do you not think that you can do this?
Till the world ends, I personally can't do it because I'm in love, not just in love with you, but I'm in love with the Holy Spirit, and I know whom I love, and I know the tendency of our love. I can never do that because it's not just a societal thing, it's my encounter. I have an encounter, but most of these women don't have encounters with God, so they could just, and that's just it. So maybe, no, if you have an encounter with God, so I don't want to take it my own route because I am a totally different person out of millions.
So what you are trying to tell us now is that any woman, any African man that is considering taking any woman out is until we should check into their encounter certificate. I don't think that's the challenge. It is not based on your encounter that will determine whether you will ask your husband or future listen to sleep on the couch, because if Eloti man bere, sleep on couch today, sleep on couch tomorrow. Before you know it, you are on the main road. I just want to believe that there is a kind of societal mismatch, because majority of these African men that are doing this, they are going extra mile, thinking that they are still in Africa. They are going extra mile to finance the so-called wives' training to become a certified nurse, a registered nurse, either in the UK, the way they say it, or whether in the US, whatever you that follows them. But the main point is this, that since we are now looking at the numerous trend, that it is now majority of African women that are beginning to throw their husband out on the street, then there is need for caution. Because I'm sure most of these men, they are running away from the kind of females they have in those Western nations, thinking that they are coming to Africa, to Nigeria, to one of their villages, to pick Agba Mary that does not know anything. But little did you know that human beings are social animals. And when they get to a place, they see opportunity to do something to their advantage. They take it full scale. But the aspect I will not support is the aspect of killing these women. Those are human lives. Human lives should never at one point in time be taken either knowingly or unknowingly. But the sad truth is that it's already occurred. So what are the lesson points about it? Take it from me. I will advise that African men should also sit back and ask themselves this question. This lady I want to bring, is she worth dying for? Do I need to register? Because now, if we are doing our permutation and combination in the group of African men, we should be able to talk to ourselves to see that it's like there is something wrong, significantly wrong, with people going into nursing. I might be wrong. If you are over there, you can advise us better. Because I'm a typical African man. If I travel over there, just know that I've come to visit. I don't have the plan of relocating. So I'm expressing myself fullest as a typical African man. But one thing I also note is that majority of the time, African men can be so authoritative to the point that we are so used to being the king, the king of the jungle. And because that is our African palace, how it is how the African environment supports it, men should be respected to the utmost. If you take it to abroad, all lawyer one. If you take that character to abroad, Obodo Imbo, you will sleep inside cell. And if care is not taken, you might lose everything that you have. But the aspect that annoys me the most is that aspect whereby the society over there turns women to now be as in the direct opposite of what is happening in Africa. I think there should be a balance.
That, Mr. Central, that's just what you're saying. There should be a balance. There should not be. See, I'm talking, when you see women that have been paid, some women are coming from the pain points. Yes, but the thing is, just to be honest, some women, most of the women, about 90% of the women, take it overboard, and that's totally wrong. Yes. So when the power now gets into their hand, they want to do and overdo, and whereas God says man is the head of the family, you can't put.
So from what you are saying now, women have the high percentage of being overdosed with taking up power over the men.
Over there abroad. And the men have 100% overdose of doing it here. I can be so sure with you. Because they want to make the woman, yes, except for men that really love their wife. They want to make women go through.
If they don't love their wife, they won't take that, because they would have been seeing more beautiful girls over there.
It's not.
They wouldn't come to Africa to come and pick this
woman. Let's even now explain that word, love. Mm-hmm. Do you know what is love?
Mm-hmm.
Love is the fulfillment of the law.
Love me according to faith.
Yes, love. No. Like you now, you offend me a lot. Mm-hmm. Every now and then, I'm just
saying. So if it's abroad now, you now see why. What I love what you are discussing, because this kind of discussion is making me to know that whenever I'm traveling out, there is no permanent visa for this thing.
God
forbid, it's not in your hand. The visa I will get for her is one I must return back to Nigeria. Yes.
It's not in your hand.
Women have the capacity of changing. That is just the difference. They have the capacity of changing overnight. And when they will change, it will be like chameleon. Yes. Oman Kapu, they are like carnival. Oman Kapu. So, advice to all you men, be careful of what you wish. It's better to just live your normal life, that both of you understand yourself here in Africa. Why not even consider, maybe I should be advising African men, if you want to get married to them and keep the women and the children here. Yes. Because after all, at the end of the day, even majority of the children that you take abroad, you don't even have control over them. The other day, I was seeing a video of a boy beating the father and the father's friend, beating them to the point that blood was dripping. So, if that kind of a child is tried that here in Africa, a genuine issue. So, I really love this discussion because I'm also learning. Because my wife just said it now on Global.
Wait, let me tell you.
I love you so very much. Come again.
God forbid.
When we travel
out. I reject it.
When we travel out, we'll come back.
Let me explain.
No woman can try that nonsense.
I trust you. My husband is so good.
I'm not a bossy husband.
In short, never.
To the extent that I operate is free speech. And I told her before my wedding, I said, I'm not coming to marry a slave. If I want a slave, upper, there are so plenty.
Yes.
I can get a slave for myself. And the slave will be giving birth to babies. But what I want is a companion, a wife material, somebody that can represent me elsewhere, and I will not have the problem of being misrepresented. That is how we started our relationship. Until date, she cannot even say that it was a day that I raised up my hand to flog her or to do any of this thing. But from this discussion, I am learning something, that human beings, they are subject to a very fractional level of change that can enter into their head and make their head to become coconut mokon.
Whatever you want to say, learn it. I'm going to say what is
so on my mind. Number one, I've learned something. Whenever you take your wife outside the country, don't let them register as a registered
nurse. So we'll go on a break right now and we'll continue.
Do you run a business that requires a warehouse space for your goods?
Or yours is just the quest to have a central point where your goods can be delivered to your customers at ease?
Regardless of the size of your business, we have got a space for you.
As we have pallet spaces for small business owners,
open large storage for your goods or product.
Maybe you are even the Odogu Patapata of them all, that you need a self-storage warehouse with your assets keys in your hand.
Our Signature Logistics has got you covered, as we have numerous automated offloading and unloading equipments for hire.
So, why do we? Give us a call today and experience warehousing solutions at its peak.
Our Signature Logistics, providing cutting-edge warehousing solutions for you.
I don't even like it. I think it's not a profession I'm interested in.
Don't worry, I will make her a registered wife.
Yes.
And it will be a registered wife in Africa.
I'm a global registered wife. I'm going across the globe. The fact is, my husband can be and is and will always be the nicest of all men. But when the husband scene of Africa comes over any man, when he shouts at you, I say, come on now, don't shout at me. We are both humans and this and that. But the thing is, I see some, my husband is very good, he's the nicest man. Let me just be honest with you. There are no two people in life, just like the tongue and the teeth, you always fight. But the infinite, we understand ourselves. When it's high, I'll be very low. When maybe at times to myself, I might be very, very this, then you will be we just overlook. That is love. That's what I'm trying to explain about love. Do you really love the person? Say, I've been built to love him. Before we married, that was what I told him. He said it was our relationship like this. I've been built to love him. I don't even see any other men. If you're a man, so sorry. I don't know, maybe you're existing like that thing.
She sees men like trees.
The fact
but I'm not tempted out with the apple. I'm going to set you across because it's like a virus there that we just compete.
It's not a virus. That virus, if it's working till the world will end, it's not going to work in me.
True.
Yes, I don't know for other women. 99.9% of women, it's my work for them because I have a goal in life. I have a destiny. I have a destination. I'm not part of just this ethnic system alone. So that's it. So do you really love that person? How on earth will you say you love a human being and you tell the person to sleep on the couch? Do you cast your mind back?
Couch is for Christians abroad.
Do you cast your... No.
See, couch, the woman still loves you when he's saying couch.
You send the man into the cold.
Out.
What of the day that man picked you? Do you know one thing like humans is that we don't roll back our memory every now and then. I used to remember how I started with my husband. There are some things I can never say anyway. It's just between us. We knew what we've been through. So when he offends me, humanly speaking, he's going to pain me. Then I'll keep praying for him. Then at the right time, I'll tell him, this thing that you did is really paining me. We'll start smiling. You will now say, that is love. Love covers a multitude of sins. It's not just that the thing will be easy. That's what most people don't know when they go into marriage. It's not going to be easy. There are some things that your husband or your wife will do to you. It's going to pain you to your marrow. It's going to really be painful. It's really going to be really painful on you. But the thing is, do you have that grace? That's when we're talking about women of grace. That's why the Bible says, every wise woman buildeth her house. Do you have that Holy Spirit that will help you? So that's just... The thing is, if you really love. Most things, yes, this reminds me. I was speaking with one of my brother friends from where I served as a youth couple. So he was actually telling me, and my husband was there some days ago. I said, that is the family. He said, they are tolerating him and he's actually tolerating them. So I smiled and I said, yes, I'm smiling in Spanish. That's how it is. So he said, don't mind some people on social media. They'll be pretending. They'll be saying love. That's it.
And the following day.
Yes, they are divorced. You have to tolerate them. They'll tolerate you. That's it. That's just being candid. You have to tolerate your husband. You know that this is weak point. He knows your weak point too. Like my own weak point now, things that a woman ought to do, I might not be able to do it. My husband and things that a man ought to do, he might not be able to do it. I'll be doing it. I'll be saying, why is it I'm doing this man's work for you? Himself will say, why is it that he's doing this woman's work for me? So that's why you're complimenting each other. And you should not allow anybody know it. You should not allow people come in between you. I think that's just it. Over there, they have this organized society and these women will be having connection with their friends that is a registered man. I don't take nonsense. How is it your husband will be controlling you? Do you want to build your own? Most of the women now, they are in the grave. And most of the men too, they are in the grave with them. So,
and that is one of the reasons why a lot of families, a lot of children that are born to such families, they ended up being in the hand of the government and their systems and manipulating the life of those children. it is not sensible for any African family to get out of the continent of Africa and start settling scores by killing each other. This is not the way to go.
So let's,
this is not how the African family setting as it is. Presently, I have my mom, my grandmom. My grandmom is over 100 years, still alive, still living in an upstairs, still climbs up and comes down. That is how Africans are. We have the grandchildren, great-great-grandchildren coming to see her and all the likes. But over there, you have to remember more anything one shape. That the meaning of that is that you have to remember the son of who you are, where you are actually coming from. If somebody, I'm not citing anybody, we are not citing anybody in today's video, because this is very, very pathetic. If someone has loved you, has shown you some level of love to the extent that they brought you from Africa, they imported you like Ghana Must Go product down there, and they spent their hard-earned money. That was one of the stories. The young man suffered doing several jobs to bring the lady from Africa, specifically Nigeria, to come and stay, have a better life with him there. And at the end of the day, this man paid for your nursing school and likes. You became a registered nurse, and the only thing to remember is the bad side.
If you know the thing is...
Wait, it doesn't make sense. Even if you remember the bad side of the man, you can settle this cause.
That is what I want to say.
Not that you now usurp power because you are in another man's land. You now usurp power, you now change. What you are condemning that is happening at home, that the men are ruling over the women, this, you now took up that same thing. You now became the opposite. Oh. No, let me tell you, it is not good. Until
the thing is, there should be mutual understanding, and I think there should be real marriage counselors there. Before people will really go into it, I don't think this system of you just taking a wife and taking her there, do you love each other? To the point that when this
person... How much of the wife do you even know? Let's even... That's another point. How much of this wife do you even know? Sometimes you spent years abroad. You spent years abroad. And this particular wife that's... sorry to say this. I'm going to be so blunt. Sometimes you spent years abroad, and majority of the time, the wife that you are coming to marry, you have only seen now during December... what's it called? Village square meeting, town hall meeting, and she's dancing at a log, and you are carried away because she knows how to wind the waist, and your family members say, good girl. Let me tell you, majority of the time, you are only coming to pick a girl that might even be in love with another shoemaker in the village, especially those of you that always travel down to the village to go and pick wife. Innocent, you call them innocent, but if you know what they are doing in the bush, you were wrong. Okay, so that's just one side of the story. But majority of the time, you guys, you did not even have a proper relationship. You don't know. You don't know whether she's somebody that
has temper, anger, or
someone that does not forgive easily. Because anybody that does not forgive easily, whatever you are doing, controlling the finances, when you are in charge, she's keeping it. And don't worry, just finish this registered nurse. I will now retire your name from my name. That's it. RN, registered nurse, retiring your name. And before you know it, she gets it. She now says, yes, this is the real me. Oh yeah, to the couch, oh Israel. Before you know it, sending you to the couch. Before you know it, and sending you outside. Let me tell you. And you also note that place is very cold. Any girl that has the mind, any girl or wife, supposed wife, that has the mind of sending you to the couch, the possibility that so-called wife is having an affair elsewhere is there. Even you, the men, so that they will not say I did not balance it well. You brought in somebody because you have sponsored him or you have sponsored her now, not him or her. We don't do men yet. You have sponsored her. At the end of the day, doesn't mean that you should not give them breathing space.
Mm-hmm.
doesn't mean that you must be the diopa of the listen. Let us unlearn some of this hyper-inflated character that of the African ceremony. You see Anna, she's free. She's expressing herself.
Because
on global TV.
You have always expressed it.
She's expressing that. No. I'm talking about you expressing yourself. If you marry some men that me and you know, you try this one. Next time they will see bandage on your face. you went online and you were talking about this thing.
You cut off the edge.
They will no. That one is this. They will remove some part of the teeth. When else you see her? You see what happened? The other will even tell us. Tell them that you fell from the dream. So okay, it's time for us to go on a short break.
Do you run a business that requires a warehouse space for your goods?
Or yours is just the quest to have a central point where your goods can be delivered to your customers at ease?
Regardless of the size of your business, we have got a space for you.
As we have pallet spaces for small business owners,
open large stories for your goods or product.
Maybe you are even the Odogu patapata of them all, that you need a self-storage warehouse with your assets keys in your hand.
Our signature logistics has got you covered, as we have numerous automated offloading and unloading equipment for hire.
So, why do we? Give us a call today and experience warehousing solutions at its peak.
Our signature logistics, providing cutting-edge warehousing solutions for you.
All these...
We're just talking of one prominent woman that lost her life due to this violence, here in Africa.
Yes,
we don't even want to remember her, and she was just patching up, and she's a non-figure across the globe, but it's so painful, she's gone now. So this thing is really...
It's becoming too much.
Before you go into a relationship, make sure you love that person. You can never, don't marry somebody you can't submit to. Take it or leave it. God is the originator of marriage.
And you remember what I told you during our courtship? I said, I can't marry a girl that if she calls me, if she says you are very stupid, I won't be able to forgive her. I told her. And that was how many years ago? About 14 years ago.
Yes.
Until date.
Yes.
Because I learned from, inception. Wedding is very easy. Marriage is the most difficult part. For you to be married to someone, before you get married, make sure that person, when he or she offends you during courtship, during your relationship, you find it easy to forgive him or her.
Yes.
If you don't find it easy to forgive him or her, that's
don't personal. Marry because don't marry.
Because when you get married, you will offend each other. It will be like autopilot. Offend. Offend. And if you cannot forgive, you will. That's how people end up poisoning their spouse.
So we've seen such. The man was sleeping, the woman brought in it, killed the man. Let there be love. Love. Please, if you don't love somebody, don't marry for the sake of money. They are taking me abroad. This life.
And don't think that because you are shipping a woman from Africa to abroad, the person will automatically love you.
That's
like some of the time, those girls, they will just pretend, let them get over there. They don't love you, they are looking for their own love. So the next thing is to help you scatter your own life. Look for their own love.
So that's actually the cause of this. So people just get into relationship, and love is what's it called? It's a mutual thing.
Yeah.
It's a two-way thing. You can't say, I remember those days, back in those days when I was still in school, some person said they loved me or they received me, and I had no emotions for them. So sorry, I can't do it. If it's God that led you to me, I must have such emotions for you too. So
let me come in here. A lot of people that are in Christendom, Islamdom, or whatever religion, most of the time you fall prey into all this brotherhood, is my sister, is my this thing in the same religion, we operate in the same faith. Please don't get it twisted. If you do not find the person that is meant for you, and you are operating on a basis, we attend the same church, we attend the same Holy Ghost night. The day they will beat you, Holy Ghost will step aside and be watching both of you, because they will beat the hell, the living day out of you. That's even if you survive. Now, always ensure that the person you want to get married to, whether he's calling the name of Jesus in every single conversation, or he's calling another religious name, please check. Can I cope with this person? Do I love him?
Can I wait? Can I submit to him?
Mm-hmm.
Can I listen to him? Can he control me? Most women don't want to be controlled, but it's wrong. You can't, you're not the head, just like the body without the head. The head is what says, yes, that's
well,
that.
American people, they don't want to hear that one. They believe that they are all equal.
Hey, so,
so they believe that they are all equal, and that's where the African men are missing it. You are bringing an African woman that does not love you that much, does not know you much, to the extent of loving you for who you are. You are bringing her abroad, and you are now becoming like a tax master. You have brought a slave. So come and be doing
what the environment is.
See, because I've heard so much. A lot of men have complained to me and my wife concerning this matter that we should talk about this. Because the most of the time, you African men, you are over there. You saw all those things. You say, I don't want to marry those that are in the state already. I want to come and bring one fresh girl that will be obeying me. Whoa, obey her. Well, the first thing is that when they land and you are giving them clothes to wash, they are washing your clothes, they are cooking your meal, they are still behaving like the typical African wife. That's obtainable in Africa. But over there, before you know it, they are going to the market space, they are going to church meetings, they are going to social gatherings, and they are beginning to hear how others are talking about their husband. You are still washing clothes for your husband. Who is this thing? Before you know it, they will start manipulating. I'm not talking of humanity now. Words manipulate the heart of men. Then I'll be like, how can I be a slave to my husband
in this free land?
Well, let me show you. They'll start changing. And you, because you are still with your African mentality that is not ready to support that, I say, let's make this thing balanced so that we can love ourselves and then stuff. See what is happening here. But if you let us live our own life in such a way that our children will not suffer, because majority of the time you guys forget about your children. You now leave those children empty. You leave them with a bad name, because I'm sure maybe abroad there you guys don't concern you are not a part of, because here in Africa, if they want to marry, and we now get the story that the father killed the mother. That's the end of the marriage. Nobody will marry. But you know, over there, when if they just see,
it's infatuation.
Over there, when they just see Tom Tom, if Tom Tom was about falling into the gutter and the man grabs it, that's love. They marry. Then 2 weeks later, they begin to say they are divorced, as if it's a foul.
And divorce is something that is just like, let's not even go into that.
It's painful.
It's so painful.
For
so,
those that are divorced, we are so sorry if any of our words offend you, but we are just coming straight.
Because there are some situations that the woman must just stay away, or the man must just stay away to be safe. It's so, so important.
Mm-hmm.
We are never against that, because there are some situations
but
that...
But if your story, is worth sharing and you want us to talk about your story, maybe I'm passing through something like this.
Yes.
And you want to give us nitty gritty of what is happening so that we can escalate, because we know some men, they are like men without the N. They are like men and they treat their women badly. To the extent that the women are just in the prison that is called relationship, husband and wife relationship. And they are just praying and say, God, just give me a job in America so that I can free myself from this shackle. Please, reach out to us on the number showing below. Let's talk about it and let's see ways of, you know, educating other people outside there so that they can be the best of this. But in general terms, please, we want to say that it is not nice for Africans. Just because you've changed your location, you now forget about who you are. You are now killing each other. You are now showing a mockery of your race, because that was one of the news. It was even police officers, I think, that made that publication that Africans are doing this, that they are now advising African husband and wife to stop doing that, that they discovered that the statistics is showing that majority of the women are sending their husband out of the house. And they are doing this just because they want to have access to this the money you did not work for, that they pay you for single parent, because I was told that they pay single parent over there. Come over to Africa, especially Nigeria. Pursue your husband. you will genuine issue. Because the government is not even thinking about you at all. You pursue your husband. Who has your people that still have their husband and this, and they are still struggling to survive. Gosh. But you are there, you are in a society that you have basic amenities, and all you can repay your husband or your wife with is to suffocate him or her. That's not the best way to go.
So even if it's not your husband or wife, love is powerful. You can't have your neighbor or a human being just say, you want to see him go through that. And you know now, what the women now do to now make the men go the extra man and say, I want to kill. And it's just the two-way.
It's
a two-way thing. In fact, it's a two-way thing. So both should... You should think of yourself, this thing I'm doing, if it's done to me, will I be happy about it?
How will somebody be there? He has worked for like 20 years of his life, 30 years, 40 years of his life, before thinking of bringing you into his life to compliment him, to make him happy. You know, he's doing that because he was looking for something. Now brought you in there, and all you can do is, after you have used his money to get some certification that is called... registered nurse or whatever qualification, school certificate, and you're now earning more than him. And the only thing you can use to repay him is to make his life miserable. Collect even the house that he has gotten. You know, you guys have some laws that are protecting women over there. I wish those laws are here in Nigeria. Some men will literally... Oh, let me tell you what men will do.
Okay. So that's just it. It's so painful. Please, let's think of that word love before we go into any relationship.
And please, something just told me now, in case you are watching this video and your marriage is about going to the level of divorce. See, so far the man is not beating you, he's not showing signs of endangering your life. I want you to reconsider. There is nothing too tough that you can't rework. You understand? Because majority of children...
Children that are brought up without the nursing experience of a father, of a mother, of...
How do you control them?
They will just... And that's what is causing this society.
We have two small boys now. Sometimes you cannot... They will not even listen to
us. To me, as in
when
the boys,
they see me, I don't even need to talk. When I just look at their face,
they will just behave.
Now imagine you are the only one.
The only woman. And those children that you fail to nurse well today, they are the ones that will kill that. Oni pe omo ti a o to lo ma gbe le ti a ko ta. Omo ti a o ko lo ma gbe ile ti a ko ta. That means... That means the children that you don't train today, they are the ones that will sell the house, all your labor that you invested in your life, you've invested in. They are the ones that will just waste those labor in the later days of that
person. So with that being said, we want to say thank you so very much for coming to listen to this, our African story, and try to rebuild your home is the main thing, because... Love is a special feeling that makes two men and women, that makes husband and wife or spouse or whoever they are to come together to say, I do. Whether it is good or it is bad, you say, I do. So it is for you to grow yourself to make it flow. Let it work.
It's a work. That marriage is work. That was what I learned before I got married, when I was still in the university. That
and are you doing
marriage is work. Much, much more than doing it by the grace of God. What? See, my mouth is stopped by him. So that is just it. Want to say, please keep your joy. Whatever you're going through, your joy is your strength.
That's it.
And your strength is your life. And for you to be alive, just look away from that thing that is not giving you joy. Please kindly reach out to us if there are things we have to know and ways in which we can come in. We are a very listening couple.
Open-minded couple that is ready to assist you in whatever way.
Yes.
But you be sure is one of the best ways that we introduce balance into your home. Not the one of our animals separate. No. There is nothing cast in iron.
Yes.
Your husband that is angry today can be the meekest person tomorrow. And your wife that is becoming the maspatoatwa of the family can become the most romantic, most scintillating, pepperoni, delicious, hot baby girl.
So, because so come your way.
What about?
to a carry away next time. Catch you. We remain the setrosvlog. Catch you. Love you. Bye-bye.